Oh,
Right, I'll just hit record. I think it's probably for the best. Otherwise, we're going to be here for forever before I even get to any question. Hello, and welcome to the SWN podcast, an impromptu episode because this was supposed to be the road trip to Halloween Hijinks. I was supposed to have a little bit where I would drive to the venue, pester some of the guys that are surrounding me at the moment at before the show, and then a bit in my car in darkness on the way home. And that's, but that hasn't happened because Storm Babette has happened, and Wrestles on Halloween Hijinks has been postponed to 2 weeks' time, which I will not be in attendance for because I'm going to fireworks instead.
Per show. Per show, Billy.
Fake
Per
fan.
show.
Fake fan.
I'm a
Get a grip.
terrible person. I'm an absolute
Why are
terrible
you going
person.
to fireworks on
Yeah.
that day? Fireworks
Because,
day is the day after.
well,
Yeah, so you've got to
fireworks.
remember the 5th of November.
Yeah, it's my 20th birthday, Billy.
No one
Come on.
cares about
We'll
that.
celebrate my
Hey,
birthday. Hey, come
well,
on.
in the glorious town of Elgin,
Fireworks
it's
day is a Sunday.
in Elgin, it's on the 4th.
Don't lie.
Belly.
If I could manage, I would be there. I wasn't going to
Wrong.
Stonehaven though.
Not
Fuck that. But I
well,
would have.
Billy, this
You want
call's
to hear?
only been for a minute and you've already ruined it.
This is not going to be the most coherent episode. If anyone's watched the Day of Birth Bonanzas in the past, you know that these don't go incredibly well. But we're doing our quiz. We have four fine wrestlers on the call. You may question that, but I will introduce who's on the show. So first up, above me on the video call is the Asian sensation, past guest of the show many a time, past quiz competitor as well. It is Umar Mohammed.
Boo, fuck you,
Shut the fuck
boo.
up, right?
To
Didn't say
my
anyone.
in my left corner, right corner of the
Back to
screen, it is the current undisputed WrestleZone champion,
Wait,
who
hold on,
is
hold on, hold on, hold on,
yeah.
hold
Get,
on.
you have
Hold
get a
on.
belt. Yeah,
Hold
get. Oh wait, hold on.
on. And Reckless Intent UK champion.
There you go.
We are less than 3 minutes in. He's regretted being here, but he's got to show off his belts. It is the Lost Boy himself, Aspen.
Hi.
And to my
Very good.
right or left, I don't know, on the screen anyway, filling up the screen is Judas Gray and Ronan King.
Damn right. Can you announce me as would-be Tri-Counties Championship tonight if
Would be try you are the Tri-Counties Championship.
Kaylee
would have
will
won
wear
that
you
tonight?
like a belt. Right. Yes.
You're fine. Go on.
What are you playing, Judas? I would have smoked him.
I'm playing a very difficult game.
Is
It
it farming?
requires a thought and intelligence you could never. Actually isn't. It's Rocket League.
Is it? Yeah,
I
I was
had a
going to say
feeling
it's
it was
Rocket
Rocket
League,
League.
yeah.
And lost because my teammate was not Ronan King. So
It was me who would have won.
yeah. So now you have my undivided attention. Don't ruin it.
Okay, so we've got the teams. Well, we've got the competitors in this quiz. I have written up five rounds of questions about movie, TV, music, and Halloween related. So it's all Halloween because this is coming out on the 27th of October. So, do I just start? We'll just get on with it. We'll just plow on
Sure.
through. Let's go for it. So at the moment, I'm assuming that Ronan and Judas will be working as a duo, as a team. So
How's
hopefully,
it?
I mean,
He's
they
on his
can work
phone.
separately.
Whoa, whoa, we're on the notes app.
Yeah. Look,
Right.
Aspen,
I don't
it's
know
not
how a
hard to go
notes
back.
app, I
Back.
have
Okay,
no
what
idea how a
partner?
notes app's got anything to do with it being 2-on-1-on-1.
Go get a partner
Yeah.
then. Okay.
It's a fair
You
game.
can't.
It's a
You ain't
fair
got any
game. But
friends.
if we talk about you,
It's okay. He's got
where's
his
the
notes
onion?
app out for his apology afterwards.
Why don't we do the first
Well,
round?
this
And
is very
if this isn't
attractive.
working, then we'll just fucking just throw it out and just
Just skip over what Ronan just said.
I didn't even hear it, so I'll be checking the video footage later. I'll just assume that it's above board and not at all
It's definitely not halal. Oshibi.
So before we started, I did say that Halloween costumes were encouraged. Actually, Omar has got the brief, He has come as Umar Mohammed with a hat on. Got Aspen. He has a t-shirt that confirms he's got a Halloween costume. Judas is wearing some lovely makeup. To some
and a sexy makeup. Ass contact. Look at that. Okay, someone put in effort.
Ronan has come as a fan that goes to Avery Anarchy. And I went as Stone Cold Steve Austin. So I am all prepared. I will say what quite a lot because of the signal. Right, first round, movie round. It's called the scary movie round because I really panicked with these. Question one, which movie tops Rotten Tomatoes list of the scariest horror movies ever? So we'll do all 10 questions, go through the answers at the end. You tell us how many you got.
Ronan's Googling.
Yeah, honestly,
there is no prize at the end of this, so you know, unless you really want one, I will organize a prize for Christmas Chaos.
I don't think it's like scary. I don't think it is, but I think that's what it says it is. You know what?
If it's then Rotten Tomatoes is a bitch.
I'll repeat that again for everyone listening. If they're still listening at this point, we're not even started. Which movie tops Rotten Tomatoes' list of the scariest horror movies ever? Question two. In The Nightmare Before Christmas, Halloween Town and Christmas Town are featured. Name another town that Jack Skellington sees the door for.
I do know the source of it. Why am I here? Are you here?
Yeah, it's a great question.
I've never even seen that film. Never?
It's because you're old.
Oof. It's quite old.
I'm a little bit offended because I think I'm older than Aspen.
I don't know. Maybe.
So that question was, in The Nightmare Before Christmas, Halloween Town and Christmas Town are featured. Name another town that Jack Skellington sees the door for. Question three, in Ghostbusters, what is the name of the infamous ghost with a ginormous appetite?
Ah, shit. Billy, could you repeat that, please?
I will do so. In Ghostbusters, what is the name of the infamous ghost with a ginormous appetite?
I feel like Scotty would be very disappointed if I didn't get this.
Scotty's always disappointed you, Omar. Just like your family when you lost family fortunes.
Shut up! Touchy subject.
I hope that's one of the questions.
I forgot to mention we've got a quiz veteran on the podcast. Question four. What sort of mask does Michael Myers wear in the original Halloween?
Oh, wait.
Yeah.
Is it?
Yeah.
Is that just the name of the character?
I think it's the
name of the actual character.
Yeah. Should we just slash it? You know, the right both because we're. So, ask me the question again.
What sort of mask does Michael Myers wear in the original Halloween?
Mexican.
That was a very.
You're all good. Question five. In Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, can you name the creature that breaks into Hogwarts on Halloween night?
Yeah, easy. Come on. I'm on this today.
Harry Potter.
I used to be obsessed as a kid.
Star Wars kid.
I was also a Star Wars kid. I had a lot of things as a kid.
Ronan was a lot of things as a kid. That's the quote there. In Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, can you name the creature that breaks into Hogwarts on Halloween night?
Ronan literally was a kid 2 years ago. What are you going on about?
He's like still under 20, so he's still a kid. He's still a kid now.
I'm not an avid.
Question six. Where was Hocus Pocus filmed?
Oh, God. I only saw this film like 2 days ago. The first time.
Question six. Where was Hocus Pocus filmed?
If it's where it's set, then yeah.
Question seven. The Pixar film Coco is based on which Mexican holiday?
No, it's not. It's not Cinco de Mayo. It's a. Oh, now I know. Yeah.
The Pixar film Coco is based on which Mexican holiday?
Easy.
Right, well, good. Question 8. Patrick Swayze and Demi Moore star in what movie about the afterlife?
I don't know.
Oh, is he the guy in Dirty Dancing?
I've never seen Dirty Dancing. I have no idea.
About the afterlife. Who was the other name?
Patrick Swayze and Demi Moore star in what movie about the afterlife?
Oh, okay. I don't know who this is either.
Yeah,
okay.
So, question 9. Which 1999 horror film was promoted with the following tagline? In October 1994, three student filmmakers disappeared in the woods near Burkittsville, Maryland. 1 year later, their footage was found.
Yeah. Okay, I know this one. Just because I saw a meme of it the other day.
You're like a... I've seen it and then you say it and I'm like, that's... I just don't know the name of it.
So again, which 1999 horror film was promoted with the following tagline? In October 1994, three student filmmakers disappeared in the woods near Burkittsville, Maryland. 1 year later, their footage was found.
Emily Hayden's watching this and she's disappointed. Sorry, Emily.
Yeah.
Okay. Sorry.
And final question of the round. What do Dr. Frankenfurter, Pennywise, and Long John Silver have in common?
I don't know Pennywise.
My best guess.
So once again, what do Dr. Frankenfurter, Pennywise, and Long John Silver have in common?
Yeah. I'm better than I thought I would.
They always like kids. They always just like kids.
Right.
Yeah, okay.
The scary movie round. Okay, so first question. Which movie tops Rotten Tomatoes' list of the scariest horror movies ever? Anyone going to go for it?
No.
No. No. It's The Exorcist.
Oh, okay.
We didn't get that. Shut up. That is bullshit, okay? That film came out. I watched it when I was like 6 and I laughed. Okay, it's an old ass film.
I've never seen it. It's not good. I want to see the second one though. It's decent.
Question 2. In The Nightmare Before Christmas, Halloween Town and Christmas Town are featured. Name another town that Jack Skellington sees the door for.
I've never seen this film, but going by the other names, I've wrote Hanukkah Town.
No.
I mean, I wrote Tinseltown.
The other towns you could have had were Easter Town, Thanksgiving Town.
Yeah.
Or Valentine's Town.
That's horrendous.
You know. Should have been a Hanukkah Town.
Should have been E-Town. Yeah, where's that?
Listen, when we celebrate real holidays over here, okay?
Eid's not a holiday. Oh.
But you want to fight me?
Ronan King does not agree with all of just race political views.
Well, you got the notes app ready, just in case. Right. Question 3. In Ghostbusters, what is the name of the infamous ghost with a ginormous appetite?
Is this Slimer?
Omar. Yes, Slimer.
Yeah. Yes. All right.
Yeah.
Too easy. Easy days.
Question 4. What sort of mask does Michael Myers wear in the original Halloween?
William Shatner.
Yes. Inside out, William Shatner mask.
What did you write, Omar? Come on, look at his face. What have you done?
I just wrote a leather mask.
Okay.
Question 5. In Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone, can you name the creature that breaks into Hogwarts on Halloween night?
Yeah. A troll.
Yeah.
Mountain troll? Troll? I will accept troll as well.
Yeah, that's good.
Question 6. Where was Hocus Pocus filmed?
America.
I need a bit more specific.
I was going to write America and then decide to write Pakistan.
I wrote Basingstoke. I don't know.
Can we like just pick a random state?
Well, the answer is Salem. The Salem Masters.
Oh, okay.
That would make sense, yeah.
Oh, I'll put Pakistan.
Question 7. The Pixar film Coco is based on which Mexican holiday?
Day of the Dead.
Correct. Day of the Dead.
Yeah.
Question 8. Patrick Swayze and Demi Moore star in what movie about the afterlife?
Ghost?
Ghost.
Yeah.
That one, they like try and enter the afterlife.
I don't know. I
don't know. There's something about a pot being made.
Yeah, that's all I know. That's the pot bit. Question 9. Which 99 horror film was promoted with the following tagline? In October 1994, three student filmmakers disappeared in the woods near Burkittsville, Maryland. One year later, their footage was found.
The Blair Witch Project.
Yes, Blair Witch Project. And final question of the round. What do Dr. Frankenfurter, Pennywise, and Long John Silver have in common?
They're all played by the same dude.
Can you name the dude?
I just wrote by the same dude.
I just wrote played by the same actor. I can't
remember his name. Surely that's still the answer.
Yeah, that is still the answer. It is still the answer.
Thank you.
I would have preferred all characters played by Tim Curry. But
I couldn't get the name out of my head.
Technically, you are correct by saying that they're all played by the same actor. So that's fine. So yeah, we'll take that. So first round in.
Technically, we were correct by saying America.
No. You're not going to put it.
What's this hatred against the young folk?
We did decent. So, I mean, you've got it. So, Aspen, you have 8 from your hand thingies. Fingers, that's the word. 8, right.
Eight.
Omar has 4.
Little 4.
What is it?
And Team Young, not the young team. I mean, we've got
6.
Is that
6?
6. Okay.
Yeah.
There we go. Right. So after the first round, the champ is in lead. So he's beaten the youngins. Right.
Not for long.
So next round is called the Boozic round. It's a music round.
Oh my god!
Yeah, I finished this about 10 minutes before I started the call. So it's
what's that on the thing behind you, Omar?
Which one?
The blue thing.
The blue thing. That's the spray bottle.
Oh, it was bloody! I thought it was a butt plug. Sorry.
That's not very halal. Nah.
That's not halal. God. Fuck. Where did I put that?
Don't tell me.
Yeah, it's away.
Boozic round. So 10 questions about music, funnily enough. Okay. Question 1. Name the band that sang Pet Sematary, which originally belonged to the 1989 cult classic film of the same title.
It's not called Pet
Sematary? No, that's just...
So that's name the band that sang Pet Sematary, which originally belonged to the 1989 cult classic film of the same title.
I know.
Yes, that's the one.
He's Googling.
No, we're not. Like, I would show you, but our answers are two.
Yeah, right? Get on our wavelength.
Did I show you the answer?
Did you write One Direction?
Oh, we read it. Oh, no.
Okay. Next.
What year was the song Monster Mash released?
Before I was born.
I will take 1 year either side.
1 year either side?
Yeah.
Is it before or after Billy Strachan?
It's older than I am.
Okay.
Yeah, okay.
So that is, what year was the song Monster Mash released? Question 3. Vincent Price provides the spooky monologue at the end of what song?
I think so.
Come on. common knowledge.
Who?
Vincent Price provides the spooky monologue at the end of what song? Question four. In what year did the Rocky Horror Picture Show first open?
You said there's a music round, not a film round.
Well, it's a musical.
This is the second one that's not been a song.
But the first one's named the band that sang Pet Sematary, so it's still music. So that's question.
I've written Dunno twice already, so.
So for that's in what year did the Rocky Horror Picture Show first open?
I'll just guess. You know what? I'll have a go at it. Okay.
You do that.
Give it a try.
If we win this, can we like take both those belts? I feel like that's only right.
How about I give you the Reckless Intent Hardcore title that's sitting over there?
Yeah, I'll take it. Yeah.
Hell yeah.
I'm about to turn 20. I kind of need a belt.
It's 24/7 anyway, so if you beat me, you kind of have to get it. So, next question.
Question five. Ghost Town was the only number one single released by which British band?
Oh, some bitch.
Kanye West also released Ghost Town. It was a banger.
That's not the answer I'm looking for. I'll tell you that as a clue. Ghost Town was the only number one single released by which British band?
I don't know the band, but
question six.
Yeah.
I didn't realize I've got two Nightmare Before Christmas questions, but here it is. Which 1980s band did the Nightmare Before Christmas composer Danny Elfman perform in?
I don't know. I'm going to write Dunno again.
What was that question again?
Which 1980s band did the Nightmare Before Christmas composer Danny Elfman perform in?
But it's not even like a real band, is it?
No, it is a real band.
I bet you just made it up.
I mean, it's going to sound like I've made it up, but it's definitely a real band. Question seven. An invisible man sleeping in your bed is the lyric from which hit belonging to the 80s movie of the same title?
Yeah.
An invisible man sleeping in your bed is the lyric from which hit belonging to the 80s movie of the same title?
The song in the thing that the film at the same time.
Damn it, Billy. Damn it. I thought you were better than this.
As you can see, I really struggle with the music round. I shouldn't have done it. I should have just picked something else.
I looked on Google before this quiz started about my general.
That's another movie one. And then the one before that was about a guy from a movie.
To be honest, a lot of the music ones are movie related, but they're still kind of music as well.
There's been like two actual music questions.
Listen,
right, you're not gonna like the next one. Question eight. Name the legendary singer who starred playing the Goblin King in Labyrinth.
You really struggled with that one, didn't you, Billy?
I hated this round.
I was so excited. I was like, I'm going to go up there. I'm going to steal his little camera. It's going to be great. I'm going to interview everyone. That way people that actually listen.
But no.
Our audio listeners are doing really well at the moment. I don't know what
I've done. You're welcome, because it's me listening to people talk about me.
Your questions are appreciated.
I'm not a maniac. I'm just self-obsessed.
Question eight, again, is name the legendary singer who starred, played... I've fucked up writing that question. Name the legendary singer who played the Goblin King in Labyrinth. Here we go. Here's a music one next. Question nine, which group famously sang about zombies?
What?
Okay, the song is called Zombie. Who sang it?
Nah, you can't. What is this?
Okay.
I'm giving them clues now.
It's like the number one song of the Rugby World Cup this year.
Shut up. Okay. You won't
know. So, which group famously sang about zombies? And the final question of the round is name the lead singer of the Smashing Pumpkins.
Oh,
the guy who was in charge of TNA. That's all I know of this. The bald guy. Billy Stratton, but in TNA.
If I shave my beard off, I probably do look like him. Name the lead singer of the Smashing Pumpkins, question 10. Oh, right. Any you need read out? Are you quite happy with that?
No, let's just get this over with.
You've definitely regretted wanting to be on. So Music Round, first question, name the band that sang Pet Sematary, which originally belonged to 1989 cult classic film the same title.
Ramones.
Correct.
Never heard of that.
You've never heard of the Ramones. Get right. Mute him.
Question two. What year was the song Monster Mash released?
Okay.
I want to take a punt at it.
Okay. How close do we need to be?
Well, I was going to give you 1 year either side, but if we're all wildly wrong, I may give a point to the one.
Was it 1984?
Okay.
84, Omar. Where are
what
you
did
from?
You? What did you? I've said 1960.
62.
It's 1962.
Oh, come on. They looked that up.
Can we get double points? Because we nailed it.
I thought it was an 80s song.
I don't know if you're
like not close enough, no.
Unfortunately not. As
Jesus, I thought I was really confident.
Bang on.
Vincent Price. Useless old folk.
Question three. Vincent Price provides a spooky monologue at the end of what song?
Thriller.
It's Thriller.
Yeah, what are you going to say now, Aspen, huh? How'd you not know that?
Just didn't. That's kind of like how a quiz works.
Question four. Same rules apply for the Monster Mash question. Nearest one, I'll give the point to. In what year did the Rocky Horror Picture Show first open?
88.
I said 87.
1984, again.
Omar gets the point. It's 1975.
What? Nah.
Like almost the same age as that.
I don't think so.
You're not like ancient.
33.
You look older.
Judas, you're older than me.
Yeah, but I'm better looking, so shut up.
What is that? You got.
I mean, Omar, you can't even argue with that. Just.
Yeah, even
that, you know,
hey, shut up,
you know, racist.
Yeah,
racist.
Question five. Ghost Town was the only number one single released by which British band?
The Specials.
The Specials, correct.
I just said random band. I just wrote Queen. I don't know.
Which 1980s band did the Nightmare Before Christmas composer Danny Elfman perform in?
Blink-182.
Fuck. I want to go for it. No.
No.
It is Oingo Boingo.
That's not real.
That's my favorite.
That's not real. Tell me one song.
That's the name of Omar's finish.
no one ever sees it because he never wins a match.
Oh.
Right.
Question seven.
I feel like we got on the wrong foot here. Okay.
Yep. Question
what
seven.
What has happened?
Question seven. An invisible man sleeping in your bed is a lyric from which hit belonging to the 80s movie of the same title?
Ghostbusters.
Correct.
Ghostbusting
in
love. Fuck,
man.
Oh, no, I'm so sorry.
Jesus.
Dave the legendary singer who played the Goblin King in Labyrinth.
David Bowie.
Yeah.
Question
nine. Which group famously sang about zombies?
Cranberries,
yep. And question 10. Name the lead singer of the Smashing Pumpkins.
Adam Pearce.
Billy Corgan.
Billy Corgan, correct.
Okay. You know, right. We did. I thought we would.
Look up.
Yeah. You passed.
Yeah.
Right, how many? So you got... seven in that round. I just really struggle with that, right? Six for Omar. And apparently 10. Did you get five? Okay, that's fine. Right. Okay.
What, do you not believe us?
Well, the fact that you thought Queen sang Ghost Town was kind of my tip off there.
Right.
It was kind of. So Aspen's got 15. Judas and Ronan collectively have 11. And Omar is got on 10. So everyone's doing.
Fuck you, Omar.
Well.
Next round is called Scare-a-Vision. It's a television round.
It's all going to be about movies that have been on the telly, is it?
I'm going to obviously double check. No, it is all.
Why are you all salty?
Me?
Okay, there is one you may not like in this question set. But anyway, Scare-a-Vision.
Okay.
Question one. In the Friends episode, the one with the Halloween party, what costume did Ross wear?
That's, like, not fair.
I don't know. I have a weird image of seeing that.
What?
But, no, because he was a...
So, in the Friends episode, the one with the Halloween party, what costume did Ross wear?
It'll be something stupid to do with that.
Yeah.
Question two. Yeah. Who starred as Fox Mulder in the series X-Files?
Have you ever seen X-Files? Gene Murray.
So that's who starred as Fox Mulder in the series X-Files?
That one's going to be a dunno.
These both have the same answer so far.
Question three. Name the actress who played Wednesday in the Wednesday Netflix series.
Oh, you know.
We all know. Omar Mohammed definitely
does. Yeah, like Omar, why'd you know? That show is definitely not halal.
What? Wednesday?
Yeah.
What? Why is it not halal?
They probably, you know, like, ate bacon at some point or something.
No. Give me a full explanation of why that's not halal.
Do you see the show?
Yeah. I don't need to explain it to this man. Okay.
My partner refuses to explain.
I abstain.
Question four. What is the surname of Sabrina the Teenage Witch?
That's what I was going to say.
The Teenage Witch.
Hello. I'm regretting doing this.
Why?
Are you...
Because Ronan and Judas are in the same room and they're quite clearly Googling.
But they're not winning.
We're not even winning. Yeah.
So they're really bad at Googling.
I'm cultured swines.
Yeah.
Oh, no, he should.
Yeah.
Oh, no.
I missed that question entirely.
So that was question four. What is the surname of Sabrina the Teenage Witch?
I think Emerson has been providing answers.
She's just walked in.
But I know this one!
Don't say it!
Oh my
god, I'm thinking!
So Omar is the only one on his own.
I'm not cheating, I've not even spoken to anyone. Right, she came down to eat, apparently.
We're believing that those guys aren't Googling. We're believing that nobody's getting any outside help. Question five. What is The Simpsons' annual Halloween special called?
What is The Simpsons' annual Halloween special called?
The Simpsons episode released on the 31st of October every year.
Question six. Which Beetlejuice actress also stars in Stranger Things?
I know that was
one of the ones I thought that I had an issue with.
Because it's about a film again.
The next one's also annoying then.
Sure.
So that's which Beetlejuice actress also stars in Stranger Things?
Alright. I was about to write an actor.
And question seven. Bates Motel is the prequel to which horror film? Question seven again. I've read it once. Bates Motel is the prequel to which horror film?
Have I missed a question? I've only got six answers.
Right. Okay. So
I've got the Simpsons one, and then I've got the last one.
Oh, so which Beetlejuice actress also stars in Stranger Things? That was question six.
I'm gonna write Dunno.
Wait, are you not thinking?
Okay, so eight.
The Netflix series Ratchet is inspired by which classic 1962 novel?
That one more time?
What? Question eight. Question eight. The Netflix series Ratchet is inspired by which classic 1962 novel?
Ratchet. Yep. Works for me.
Question nine. In Brooklyn Nine-Nine, during the fifth Halloween heist, what does Raymond Holt refer to the prize, the championship belt, as?
Should have asked me like who won or something.
That, well, I think the fifth one is particularly contested and who won it. Brooklyn Nine-Nine, during the fifth Halloween heist, what does Raymond Holt refer to the prize, which is a championship belt, as?
Everyone else is awfully quiet, I'm just saying.
I've never watched that show.
That's because you need to get sorted out.
You like it, you should watch it.
Question 10, final one of this round. On 31st of October 1992, the BBC petrified the nation with Ghost Watch, a scripted drama that duped viewers into believing it was a live transmission from a haunted house. Who presented it?
When? 1992.
1992, 31st of October 1992.
I feel like this is not fair.
I know his second name, but I don't know his first name. Damn it.
That would terrify me.
I can guess what Ronan's put, and I don't think it's that. On 31st of October 1992, the BBC petrified the nation with Ghost Watch, scripted drama that duped viewers into believing it was a live transmission from a haunted house. Who presented it? Right, all good. Any repeat questions required?
No.
I think we're all good.
No.
Wait, number eight.
I've got a lot that just says done also.
Right, so we'll just...
What was number eight again?
Number eight was the Netflix series Ratchet is inspired by which classic 1962 novel?
Oh, I know this one. Yeah, okay.
I feel like he is just...
Okay. In the Friends episode, the one with the Halloween party, what costume did Ross wear?
Spudnik.
Yeah.
Who the fuck is that?
Oh, it's when he wears the plate with a suit thing on his head.
Colander.
Yeah, that's...
Question two. Who starred as Fox Mulder in the series X-Files?
Gene Money.
Danny DeVito.
You know, I think Aspen's going to kick himself. He's very close. It's David Duchovny. Duchovny. You know, that's close. No, David Duchovny.
Can I get it then?
No. Unless you put the Coveney. Question three. Name the actress who played Wednesday in the Wednesday Netflix series.
Jenna Ortega,
correct. Question four. What is the surname of Sabrina the Teenage Witch?
G Money.
Is it Spellman?
It's Spellman.
Oh, I knew that. Forgot.
Question five. What is the Simpsons annual Halloween special called?
Treehouse of Horror.
Oh. Yep. Question six. Which Beetlejuice actress also stars in Stranger Things?
Winona Ryder.
Yep. Question seven. Bates Motel is the prequel to which horror film?
Psycho.
Yep. Question eight. The Netflix series Ratchet is inspired by which classic 1962 novel?
Is it One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest?
It is. One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest.
Okay, sure.
You tell me to read.
What did you put?
G-Money.
We put G-Money.
Oh, okay, right. Question nine. In Brooklyn Nine-Nine, during the fifth Halloween heist, what does Raymond Holt refer to the prize championship belt as?
A cummerbund.
There we go.
Okay.
That's what I'm going to call it. I take your title, Aspen. My prize, cummerbund.
I'm not wrestling you for any belts.
We're wrestling mentally right now for that hardcore title.
All right, okay.
Yeah, in your place.
On the 31st of October 1992, the BBC petrified the nation with Ghost Watch, a scripted drama that duped viewers into believing it was a live transmission from a haunted house. Who presented it?
Is it Michael Parkinson?
It was Michael Parkinson.
Oh.
Is that G-Money's shoot name?
I can't believe G-Money didn't do any of these things.
What the hell do you
do? Right. How many? How many did you get?
Oh, I was about to run out.
Six from Aspen.
No, five. You dumb fuck.
Yeah, fuck. I'm... Yeah.
Seven from Omar. Good drive from Omar there. And you guys got five. Okay. So we're on Aspen with 21. Ronan and Judas on 16. And Omar is on 17. So even though they've got two brains, they're in last place at the moment.
You know, no one asked your opinion, okay?
Yeah, we're
no one's watching this for you.
Why does it matter?
I agree with that, actually, that statement. Nobody watches it for me. Next round is called Halloween Havoc. It is the actual wrestling content on this podcast.
Right, here we go.
So all of these questions are about the event Halloween Havoc in all its iterations, NWA, WCW, and NXT. I hope I've got these right. And I feel like from the stretching I'm seeing from the competitors here, if I've got it wrong, I will find out about it very quickly. So Halloween Havoc, question one. At the 1997 edition of WCW Halloween Havoc, Rey Mysterio bested Eddie Guerrero in a classic matchup for the WCW Cruiserweight Championship. What was the opening match for the event? So that is at the 1997 edition of WCW Halloween Havoc, Rey Mysterio bested Eddie Guerrero in a classic matchup for the Cruiserweight Championship. What was the opening match for the event?
I'm going to move myself from this.
There's been like one hell of a Halloween.
Don't you say anything.
Question two. In 1991, Halloween Havoc featured a Chamber of Horrors match. Who ended up shocked in the electric chair?
Oh,
I feel like this is quite biased. The older people in it.
Yeah, I don't know. I'm sure that guy.
It's not very fair.
Seems like a spooky guy.
Yeah, he seems like some theme to that.
Yeah.
So can you repeat that again?
I will do so. In 1991, Halloween Havoc featured a Chamber of Horrors match. Who ended up shocked in the electric chair? Question three is one for the younger ones. 2020 was the first NXT edition of Halloween Havoc. Who did Dexter Loomis defeat in a Haunted House of Terror match?
I
don't know.
I remember watching the show, but I don't remember. I really think it was him.
I can barely remember the last name. I know Seth Rollins.
He was good.
So that's 2020 was the first NXT edition of Halloween Havoc. Who did Dexter Loomis defeat in a Haunted House of Terror match? Question four. 1992 was Spin the Wheel, Make the Deal. What was the stipulation for Sting versus Jake the Snake Roberts? So that's 1992 was Spin the Wheel, Make the Deal. What was the stipulation for Sting versus Jake the Snake Roberts? Question five. Who defeated Hulk Hogan at the 1995 edition of the event to win their first WCW World Heavyweight Championship?
False, no one ever beat Hogan.
I feel like I actually shouldn't listen. At 1995, when their first...
Who defeated Hulk Hogan at the 1995 edition of the event to win their first WCW World Heavyweight Championship? Question six. At the 2022 NXT edition of the event, who did Mandy Rose defeat to retain the NXT Women's Championship?
Say that again, Billy.
At the 2022 NXT edition of the event, who did Mandy Rose defeat to retain the NXT Women's Championship? Question seven. In which city did NWA Halloween Havoc 1989 take place?
In which city did 1989's Halloween Havoc take place?
Yes.
Did you change it to city because we said America last?
Oh.
Well, it was already set as city, but it's worked out in my favor. So which city did NWA Halloween Havoc 1989 take place? Question 8. At Halloween Havoc 2000, there was a kickboxing match to decide the WCW commissionership. Who won?
What
year? 2000. Oh, it was...
So at WCW Halloween Havoc 2000, there was a kickboxing match to decide the WCW commissionership. Who won? Question 9. Who defeated Harlem Heat to win the WCW Tag Team Championships at the 1996 event?
This went worse than I thought it was going to.
This has been abysmal.
So that's who defeated Harlem Heat to win the WCW Tag Team Championships at the 1996 event.
1996.
What tag team?
And the final question: what was the tagline for the 1990 Halloween Havoc event?
Say one more time.
So, what was the tagline for the 1990 NWA Halloween Havoc event?
Do you think it'll be a play on the fact that it's going to be the year 2000?
I think I've missed like four questions. If we've done all 10.
We've done all 10.
I think I've missed like four.
Right. Okay. So I'll quickly.
Because I was trying to remember answers and then.
I'll give you the years of each and then anything you need to like. I'll get that. Well,
you give me the years of each.
Yeah, because they're all about a year. Well, the first question.
How's that going to help me? Because I don't know the question.
Well, okay.
You can tell me the year and then just say all the questions quickly.
All right. At the 1997 edition of WCW Halloween Havoc, Rey Mysterio bested Eddie Guerrero in a classic matchup. Could have skipped that bit. What was the opening match for the event?
Okay.
In 1991, Halloween Havoc featured a Chamber of Horrors match, who ended up shocked in the electric chair.
Okay.
2020 was the first NXT edition of Halloween Havoc. Who did Dexter Lumis defeat in a Haunted House of Terror match? 1992 was Spin the Wheel. Was Spin the Wheel Make the Deal? What was the stipulation for Sting versus Jake Roberts? Who defeated Hulk Hogan in the 1995 edition to win their first world title? At 2022 edition, who did Mandy Rose defeat to retain the NXT Women's Championship? In which city did NWA Halloween Havoc 1989 take place?
Don't have a clue.
At Halloween Havoc 2000, there was a kickboxing match to decide the WCW Commissionership. Who won?
Okay.
Who defeated Harlem Heat to win the Tag Team Championships at the 1996 event? And what was the tagline for the 1990 NWA Halloween Havoc.
Okay.
Let's right. Go. Well, good. Let's go. So, question one again. At the 1997 edition of WCW Halloween Havoc, Rey Mysterio bested Eddie Guerrero in a classic matchup for the WCW Cruiserweight Championship. What was the opening match for the event?
I believe it was Ultimo Dragon against Nagata.
Correct.
Thank you.
Yuji Nagata versus Ultimo Dragon. Question two. In 1991, Halloween Havoc featured a Chamber of Horrors match. Who ended up shocked in the electric chair?
Abdullah the Butcher.
Correct. Abdullah the Butcher. 2020 was the first NXT edition of Halloween Havoc. Who did Dexter Lumis defeat in a Haunted House of Terror match?
No idea.
No.
See, I put Duke Hudson.
It was Cameron Grimes.
Duke Hudson.
I don't know. He's still in NXT. I can't remember. Is he?
Oh. Yeah, he's part of Chase U.
That's the one.
1992 was Spin the Wheel, Make the Deal. What was the stipulation for Sting versus Jake Roberts?
Coal miner's gloves.
Correct. Coal miner's glove match.
So what was it like? What was the work there? Like,
it's a big heavy glove. Like, I think it was on a pole, maybe. I think it might have been on a pole.
I think it was.
So the first person to take it down can use it.
It didn't fare well, did it? And reviews, people did not like it. Question five. Who defeated Hulk Hogan in the 1995 edition of the event to win their first WCW World Heavyweight Championship?
The giant.
Oh, okay.
I would have accepted Big Show, but the giant sounds. At the 2022 NXT edition of the event, who did Mandy Rose defeat to retain the NXT Women's Championship?
Not a clue.
Shotzi.
Alba Fire.
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
That's fine. I don't know.
I swear she must have wrestled Shotzi at one of those Halloween shows, because I have a...
I think it was, she was
the host. She was the host, was she not?
Maybe that's why, but I swear she wrestled Mandy in one of them.
No idea. Right, question 7. In which city did NWA Halloween Havoc 1989 take place?
It New was York.
Philadelphia.
Ah, shit. It's like looking good.
At Halloween Havoc 2000, there was a kickboxing match to decide the WCW commissionership. Who won?
Okay. I think it was Ernest the Cat Miller.
He defeated Ernest the Cat Miller.
Ah,
it was above average Mike. Above average Mike Sanders.
I was about to say it. I knew it was one of them because I remember the match, but I couldn't remember who won.
No, I put Vince Russo.
And I put Ernest Miller because he was like the martial arts guy. I assume there was some cheating going on.
Question 9. Who defeated Harlem Heat to win the WCW Tag Team Championships at the 1996 event?
Hawking Animal.
It was the Outsiders. Scott Hall and Kevin Nash. And finally, what was the tagline for the 1990 NWA Halloween Havoc event?
Terror rules the ring.
Correct. It was Terror Rules the Ring.
Yeah. Is it not Sid Vicious? It's Sid Vicious not on the poster. I remember that.
I think so, yeah. I didn't check that.
So...
Right. Scores. Aspen 5. 0 for Omar. Oh. Judas and Ronan. Any advance on 0?
No.
Oh my god.
Aspen is clearly within 26.
I thought I did absolutely terrible on that, so I'm pretty surprised.
So it feels almost academic.
2000 onwards.
It feels almost academic at this point because Aspen is 9 points ahead of his nearest rival. So if he just gets one question right, he is one.
It might be a bad round.
I didn't think of none of them are funny. A punny name for the last round. It's just general knowledge. So I'm sorry, guys. I failed. So final 10 questions. Glad I didn't organize tiebreaker. I don't think I'll need it, but you never know. Omar could get 10.
Billy, why support us, huh? Why are you always hating on me?
I mean, if you get 10, you're only 26. So
why are you always hating on us, though? Why are you always rule us out?
What's Aspen on?
Aspen's on 26.
Okay. So you could.
All you need to do is get one right and have won the whole game.
Yeah, but shut up. Okay.
So the final round.
Yeah, add some intrigue to it.
Oh, we could have a three-way tiebreaker here.
Double point.
Every good YouTube video, you make them double points. You make it get that ad revenue. 10 minutes.
Do you want me to just throw this round so he has to do a on the fly?
Yeah.
Please.
Can we Google the answers at the same time?
No.
I mean, we thought that these two in the corner would be Googling their answers, and they have failed.
No, clearly not.
Clearly not. Anyway, general knowledge. Thanks. Last round. Who wrote Frankenstein in 1880? Oh, sorry, not 1880. 1818. Who wrote Frankenstein in 1818?
In 1818?
Yes.
It's almost as old as Sweaty Swift.
So who wrote Frankenstein in 1818? Question 2. In which country is Transylvania located?
Oh, God.
When
Where's Transylvania?
Oh, it's in that one, like, that's here on up here on the map.
I'm going to need it a bit more specific, if possible. Of which country is Transylvania located? Question three. What vegetable was originally carved to create a jack-o'-lantern before the pumpkin?
Actually, do know this one. I just forgot. I know what it is, but if you mean then.
So that is, what vegetable was originally carved to create a jack-o'-lantern before the pumpkin?
It was a... I got it.
Question four. Where does the quote, double, double, toil and trouble, come from?
Oh, it's...
That's question four. Where does the quote, double, double, toil and trouble, come from?
That's where they do it.
Question five. How many witches were burned at the stake in the Salem witch trials?
An exact number, or you want close, or
close. Closest gets it.
If we get it, bang on. Can we just get 10?
Is it more or less than you'd think?
Less than you'd think.
Okay.
So that's how many witches were burned at the stake in the Salem witch trials?
Clearly not enough.
There may be a technicality point on that one, but we'll get to it if I need to. Six, are pumpkins technically a fruit or a vegetable?
No.
I got the answer.
So that's question six. Are pumpkins technically a fruit or a vegetable?
I think so.
Question seven. What is a group of witches called?
Oh, yeah. This is my round. I bet you they're all wrong, like, but this is my round.
It was really? Oh, man. I think so.
What is a group of witches called? Question eight. What is the name of the fourth and final novel in the Twilight saga? I bet Judas has got this one. You seem...
The fuck is that supposed to mean?
You seem Twilight-y.
Yeah, I can see like that.
Take it back. Yes, I've seen them. Okay.
So what is it? Fucking hell.
I don't know that one.
What is the name?
Was that eight?
That was number eight.
Right, okay.
So what is... I'm sorry, Jesus. That was a necessary slam.
Yeah, it was.
What is the name of the fourth and final novel in the Twilight saga? We're just about the end of the quiz, and my pure brew has kicked in. Excellent. Question nine. What famous magician died on Halloween?
Famous magician?
Yes. What famous magician died on Halloween?
I don't know any famous magicians.
Oh my god, what? This is I think all like Ronan and Judas need to do is just get like two, and they beat me because I have no idea about any of this.
And the final question, you'll all be glad to hear. I think we're just about on the hour mark, which everyone will be glad to know. What does the German word poltergeist literally translate to?
Spooky, scary skeleton. What does it literally translate to?
Yes. What does the German word poltergeist literally translate to?
I had a guess, but
no, because there's a difference. Well, is it?
So in the final round here, we could see a three-way draw, perhaps. General knowledge. Question one. Who wrote Frankenstein in 1818?
Mary Shelley.
Mary Shelley is correct.
What did you write? I need to know.
Nothing.
No.
What was it?
We just didn't read Lizzie Roden. No.
Did you write Mary Berry?
No, I knew it was a woman, but that's all I knew.
Question two. In which country is Transylvania located?
Is it Romania?
It's Romania, correct?
Okay. I wrote that as a guess, but I didn't want to say it out loud in case it was wrong.
That lacks confidence.
Omar, I bet you got that wrong.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I got that wrong. I didn't write anything.
Well, Omar, you need to get more. You need to get more than them.
God.
Because you're never going to live it.
We're tying now, right?
Yeah. I think so. Yeah. What vegetable was originally carved to create a jack-o'-lantern before the pumpkin?
I think it's a turnip. A neep.
I put a squash.
Yes.
Oh no!
Say, yeah, you want to know what this man originally wrote? He looks at me dead in the eye and goes, "Potato." I'm like, the fuck.
I got turnip. I did get turnip eventually. I switched it.
Question four: where does the quote "double double oil and trouble" come from?
Macbeth. Is it Macbeth?
It's Macbeth.
That was in Harry Potter.
I swear to God.
That's the one question for Reece Dawkins.
The only reason I remember that is because that was the name of like a recent episode of Ahsoka where there was witches in it.
Oh, cool. I'm watching.
So, question five: how many witches were burned at the stake in the Salem witch trials?
Right, how close are you want us to get?
That's the closest person.
Okay, you said to me it was less than you'd expect. Oh, so I expected like 1,000. So I wrote 245.
Okay.
I put 602.
152.
The young guys get it. It's zero.
Yes! How many?
Zero.
There was no witches burned at the stake. There's 25 innocent people killed, but there was no witches burned at the stake.
Wait. They wouldn't have been put to the stake unless they'd been proven to be witches in the trials.
Yeah. Well, so only 25 people then were burned at the stake.
Yeah, we're still closest.
We're drowned.
All right, whatever. All right, keep going.
Six. Are pumpkins technically a fruit or a vegetable?
Technically, they're a gourd.
What's the option I've got here?
I don't care. That's the technicality. They're a gourd.
Fruit or vegetable?
Look up, they're a gourd.
Fruit or vegetable?
They're a vegetable.
Okay, well, fruit then, because they've got seeds. But they're a gourd.
Fruit's the answer.
It's not.
It's got seeds.
It's not. But I'm going to take that as correct.
I mean, you're winning anyway.
I don't care. I need to win decisively.
It's taking you to the last round to actually properly get into it.
Well, you know what? I needed to. I'm almost finished my drink. So,
what have you got for? I went for Dropkick.
That's horrible. I've got that one.
See, I don't mind it, but it's kind of. I think it's because it's got pineapple. It seems to be burning my tongue.
It's terrible. Omar's just started drinking energy drinks this week. If anyone cares.
Yeah.
Oh, any particular favorites so far?
I saw
McDonald's.
Aspen had just there. The cherry one's actually all right.
I'm not big into cherry.
This is the start of the slow decline of his life.
I hate it.
Do you want to look it up and see that it's a gourd?
Oh my god, just say the next questions.
Oh shit, I've just dropped a drink on as well. Pumpkin, gourd. Alright, fair enough.
Right,
but
thank
still,
you.
Right, two.
Next.
Anyway, right.
Next.
Seven. What is a group of witches called?
A coven. Next.
Coven cackle. Is correct.
Oh, I thought it was a cackle.
That's what that was.
A cackle.
A cackle.
I've heard that before. Like a cackle of witches.
What?
No?
That's the noise they make when they laugh in like comic books. Cackle.
That's what I thought.
Why didn't I just think? You've got Goblin.
Oh, Coven's the right answer. Question eight. What is the name of the fourth and final novel in the Twilight Saga, Judas?
I don't know.
Breaking Dawn.
Correct.
Oh!
Yeah.
Again. I knew the movies. I knew there was like
I thought it was something to do with the moon.
Yeah, isn't that the first one?
Well, the first one's
I don't know, Omar.
Why is everyone assuming I watch bloody Twilight?
Pretty sure the first one's Full Moon, is it?
No, the first one's Twilight.
Oh, shut up.
Nine. What famous magician died on Halloween?
I don't know any. So I wrote the guy from Magic's Greatest Secrets Revealed. You know the guy with the mask?
Yeah. Anyone take a punt at it? No.
Oh, I can't remember his name. I genuinely know. Was it the one where he gets flopped in the water?
Yes. It's Harry Houdini.
Yes, I said that.
Is Houdini a magician?
Well, it's like magician? An escape artist, but I think.
Yeah, he's a. What do you mean? He's a. What are they called?
Escape artist.
Yeah, but there's a word for it. Escapologist. He's not a magician. Get out.
Final question of the whole quiz is, what does the German word poltergeist literally translate to?
Does it mean like a trickster or something like that? It's something like that, isn't it?
I would have accepted noisy spirit or rumbling ghost.
Yeah, well, it's not a rumbling ghost.
I wrote ghost and you said it was a ghost.
Yeah. I said TV ghost.
It would mean something.
Did Omar get any in that ring?
You'll find out.
So
this is where we find out.
The final time. What's your scores?
Go for Omar.
Six for Omar. 0 for Omar.
Yeah.
God damn it.
Is that six? Six. So the final total is, I'll go backwards from last to first. So it would be in last place with a whopping 17 points out of the possible 50. Omar Mohammed. You are awarded the Tom Atlas Award of being really shit at quizzes.
Oh, no one wants that. No.
So you can eat that.
In second place, with 22 points out of a possible 50, is the team of Judas Gray and Ronan King.
Come on!
Who proved that two brains don't often are not better than one. So, and in first place, with 32 points, I have a possible 50, is the current undisputed WrestleZone champion and Reckless Intent UK champion, Lost Boy Aspen.
What a nerd.
Yeah.
All right, okay, boys. You just go back to your bed, sleep top and tail tonight for your big day tomorrow, all right?
So this has been quite a nice quiz in comparison to the last couple ones we've done. It did take 5 rounds for the winner to wake up, but still was crushing every round. So you know, there you go.
I want to just point out, right? The more alert I got, the less answers I got right. I was in like some kind of zen state in the first 2 rounds. And then it just got worse.
Omar, what happened?
Oh, that half the questions were 1982.
So the thing is, I just want to let everyone know here that I know exactly where Billy got most of these questions from. I just skimmed through and saw some of the questions and I remembered the answers.
Yeah, I looked at like 5. Other than the
literally right before this quiz, I was like, oh, I have no idea about anything about Halloween. So I just looked on Google for the first quiz and then scrolled through and I was like, okay, those are some answers that I might know.
You just Googled a quiz, Billy.
Why do you think I knew the one about Ratchet and the one flew over the cuckoo's nest?
Because you're
a nerd. An hour and 12 minutes for Omar to only go and cheat and lose.
So actually, I apologize, Ronan and Judas. Omar is the one that was cheating.
I did it before the quiz. Okay, I did it.
So you cheated before the quiz happened. Even worse, because then you knew in advance.
Good. Okay.
You know Omar's got a big sticker on the boot of his car while his social media is on it, like a nerd.
Didn't I put it on Twitter one time when you were there?
So this has been a fun edition of...
Can we do the...
What? Okay, I was going to get you all to do your social media handles. Don't need to for Omar.
Yeah, well, they don't need theirs. Just do ours. It's fine.
Right. Okay, so did everyone enjoy themselves? It killed an hour and 50 minutes out of your day when you should have actually been like doing a wrestle.
I mean, I should probably be wrestling right now, if we're being honest.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, I'm good by now.
Yeah, I would have embarrassed Conor.
I would have finally been rid of Dawkins and Tucker, so, you know, that would have been fun.
I doubt that.
Shut
up. Yeah. I think they've got your number, Omar.
Yeah, Omar, just you're a loser.
And I've got Omar's number as well. Do you want to see it?
Why are you don't dox me? Don't dox me. Billy, turn the call off now. Turn the call off now.
Show it to the world.
So before I let them two do the outro, this quiz has happened because of Storm Babette. So by the time this comes out, it'll be like a week away from Halloween Hijinks, the event that should have been happening when we're recording. It's not. So I think tickets may still be available because some people put their tickets back or move them to Christmas Chaos, which is what I'll be doing.
It'll also be a week away from Discovery.
Oh yeah, and we get to see Skull Brawl.
Judas is on that as well.
Didn't pick any of the 10 names I put forward, although you did mention
Power and Glory. I wrote them on the board, though, and then I conveniently didn't read any of them out.
Well, you got Power and Glory. I was quite happy that one of them got in.
What else are we missing from the show?
Judas is on the show.
And
I assume that Omar and Ronan will be there.
No.
I'll be there.
No. Yeah. What? It's my birthday. Thanks for remembering.
It's his birthday.
When's your birthday?
The day of Discovery.
November 3rd.
I remember the Discovery show. I just won't remember his birthday.
On the same day, so you kind of can't forget.
Yeah.
Well, but I don't want to remember that's his birthday.
Wait. So everyone,
Discovery Wrestling, Portobello Town Hall, Friday. WrestleZone,
bring a card.
Aberdeen, Saturday.
There we go. That's fine, right? Social media handles, everyone knows. You would find them by now. I'll tag them in. Shit.
Omar is really hard to find because when you search his name, he's used a weird font.
I know that is quite annoying, to be honest.
But it is on the back of his car.
No, that's my Instagram.
True.
That's my Instagram.
Oh, Instagram's on the back of his car for the ladies.
Yeah.
Without further ado, then, to round up the show before I find the stop record button, which because Zoom's updated, I can't fucking find it. Rodan King, Judas Grey, outro.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen.
I've been Rodan King.
I've been Judas Grey.
Thank you very much for watching us.
And everyone else here.
Fuck Omar Mohammed. Follow at Ronan_King_ on Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, all that jazz.
Follow at Judas Grey on Instagram and at Judas Mate on Twitter.
Bye-bye.
You need to get them matching. That's just too much. How long did it take you to rehearse that, by the way?
I hate that so much.
We're just so on good. The fly. We're just pros.
Yeah,
sure,
totally worth it. Anyway, let's stop recording.